Welcome to Love Island's Under the Duvet. This is your weekly show with all of your insider gossip you need in your life. I'm Emily Siegel and I'm calling it here first. Alex, you're a mug. On the show today, we're going to be asking the big question. Has Alex shown his true colours? Do we think he's actually really quite snaky? Also, we ask, will Laura ever find true love? And we find out what you and the rest of the world have been saying on social media. Also, very exciting show today. It is the biggest lineup to date. Two couples are joining me under the duvet. I am in bed with four people, which puts a certain 22-year-old to shame. We start with Adam and Zara. Adam, let's just clear this up now.
Right.
Are you 22?
I am 22 years old. 95, baby.
Come on. 95! But you have the body of a man, Zara. Is he 22?
He is 22.
Have you seen ID?
Yeah, I've seen his passport.
Oh my God.
Do you want ID out?
We still want to see the ID. Guys, it's great to see you. You are about to get a Love Island probing. Are you ready?
Yes, let's go.
Okay, let's start with our big question, guys. Like, Alex, what is he playing at?
I think that Alex does like Alexandra. I don't really think he's playing a game, but I think he's went in with his perfect image of a girl.
Right.
And I know that as a blonde girl, is his normal type, even though he's probably more suited personality-wise to Alexandra.
Yeah.
I think he's got this magical picture of the perfect girl and it's clouding his judgment.
I agree.
Well, do you think now then he's going to try and couple up with this new girl, Laura?
No, I think you'll realise and then you'll see through it and go back to Alexandra.
He's not the kind of guy to like really step on anyone else's toes. He likes to keep the peace as much as possible. I don't think he's really confrontational.
No.
So I don't think he'd go in after Jack's kissed new Laura.
Right, so he's got morals, because we've actually heard that he's a bit of a playboy, which sounds weird because you're like, Alex, playboy?
I mean, I'd need to see Alex out. I haven't seen him out yet. Maybe when he comes out, it might be different.
But yeah, you need to go like clubbing with him or something and see what he's like.
Yeah, see what
Now, people are saying that Georgia and Sam should obviously leave because they've been like kissing and they shouldn't really kiss. What do you think about the whole Georgia and Sam situation?
I think it really depends. I mean, obviously, we're not Georgia and Sam and we've not seen, I don't feel like I've seen a huge amount of them on my screen to really be able to understand what their relationship was like beforehand. So it depends. I mean, if they were at the similar stage like what me and Adam were at, then I'd say, yeah, leave, because if you can't be together, then what's the point?
Yeah.
You're in there to meet new people. But I think that if they weren't at that stage, they weren't boyfriend and girlfriend, they weren't official, they were still seeing how things went, why would you turn down this massive experience for something that you don't know is going to work on the outside?
Because you guys...
I have seen them together. I think Sam would have left for Georgia. I don't think Georgia would have left for Sam.
Really?
Yeah.
Because everybody, actually, she was telling everybody that Sam wanted to leave, but no one believed that.
I wouldn't like to believe that.
I'm annoyed that the like silly bits aren't kind of being played out, because there was some like pictures of the guys dressing up the other day and stuff like that. And what do you feel about that? Do you want to see more of that kind of stuff?
I think everyone, as a viewer, you love a bit of drama and you love the juicy stuff. And I mean, fair play to ITV, they have a 45-minute window to show of like all of the drama that goes on in the day. Would you really miss out on a key piece of drama that's crucial to the story just for some like silly stuff? I don't know.
I agree. I prefer the drama, so no, I do agree with that. Who do you think could possibly win over Jack and Danny? Because obviously everyone says they're the favourites. Do you think anyone could kind of nip in there at the end?
I think depends if Laura couples up with Isaac Paul.
Yeah. Ooh. Oh yeah, because everyone's
really... I think Laura is really kind of... I think she's got this kind of almost sympathy vote from a lot of people because she's going through a really tough time. So, I mean, there's that possibility. And I think Josh and Kaz as well.
Yeah, a lot of people are saying Josh and Kaz. Adam, what do you think?
Kaz isn't as big of a personality as Josh, and Josh is probably carrying her a little bit, even though they're amazing together.
Yeah.
They really are, and they'd make some beautiful kids.
Oh, God, yeah, they'd be hooked. You make beautiful kids, actually. We'll get on to that very soon. Now, Charlotte Cosby was on our first show, Adam, and she says that you have applied for Geordie Shore a few times, but it didn't happen for you. Is there any truth in that?
So the guy that actually cast me for Love Island cast me for Geordie Shore.
Oh, really?
But to be honest, I don't think I could have kept up with the guys anyway.
No.
So that was it. But the show was really good back in the day, and I've got nothing against any of them.
Yeah, but just you prefer not, you went on Love Island. Thing. Now, last week we had Rosie on the show, and she had stuff to say.
Yeah.
But she said that she didn't think you guys were going to last. We didn't agree, but what do you think to that?
Well, obviously we're going to last. Yeah. I mean, Rosie's always going to say that, but it's probably hit from what she saw in the villa, and in the villa, it's a little bit different.
Yeah.
I think she was probably hoping for me and her to be like what me and Zara are, but that was never going to be the case.
Right. So it's the bitter comment that she made. Have you guys moved in together?
Not like officially, but obviously it's difficult with him like technically living in Newcastle, me in Essex, and his work is mostly like an hour from me. So he's kind of...
I mean, our dad made his breakfast this morning.
So you're in the family home. So are you doing bits in the family home?
Oh my gosh.
Our dad's going to have a few words with you. Now, we saw on Instagram, Zara, that you bought Adam some lovely gifts,
I did.
Number one girlfriend. Adam, what have you bought Zara? Is it a ring or is there anything Zara?
You get your present
later. What have I bought? Yeah, I don't really know. We went for some nice meals.
Yeah,
we have.
I probably need to step my game up a little bit.
She got you clothes, a cookie.
Yeah, I know.
Let's step it
all
up.
All my best
buy
stuff.
Buy her a ring.
Harry,
wait for them PAs to come through first, right?
You guys recently went on a double day with your best friend Ellie and Charlie, who were also in the villa. Did Charlie pick up the bill?
No.
Me and Charlie split the bill.
Really? Yeah. You shouldn't have done that. You know, he's worth like £400 million.
It doesn't matter. It's his principles. Do you know what
it is?
Charlie really took his time of saying on the show that he was worth that. I knew a week earlier and it was off camera.
Really?
Yeah. But I mean,
so you knew he's how not,
he's,
he was.
He's the most down to earth person in the world. I think when we were talking about this pair of shoes once, he was like, "Yeah, I got them in the sale. It was a really good one." And I was thinking, "You don't need the sale, mate. You do not need the sale."
Adam, you're obviously going on a massive nightclub tour.
Yeah.
Zara, how do you feel about that? Because it will just be women throwing themselves at you.
Yeah, but honestly, I'm absolutely fine.
Will you go along?
To some of them, yeah, but nightclubs aren't really my thing.
No.
Staying up late is not really my thing, so I'll just be in bed and he.
You're like me. We should I love going to bed at like 8 o'clock. We should.
Oh yeah, we should do that sometimes. Sleepover.
Now we've noticed that Ian's actually been liking a lot of your lingerie photos. Adam, how do you feel about that?
With Ian?
Yeah, he's been liking all like Zara's sexy photos.
I mean, I was with Ian the other day. Okay. I can put him in this place if he needs to be.
Guys, you've been amazing. That was your Love Island probing.
Thank you.
Listen, bad news, you are actually going to be dumped from the bed because there's going to be another recoupling.
We're not.
Yeah, I'm afraid you are. But we're going to get you back for a game of Mr. and Mrs.
Cool. Okay?
But we go to the news.
I'm Lydia with the Love Island latest, and there's more space in the villa. Now, you might have heard Sam and Georgia have quit, but all is not as it seems. The Love Island staff are keeping pretty quiet on this, but we do know there's a recoupling tonight, and that means Islanders might be dumped. In other news, Stephanie's been left in tears after finding out new Jack kissed new Laura. The gossip tore through the villa after new Jack told Dr. Alex, who told old Laura, who told Stephanie. Phew. And Stephanie's not happy because she shares a bed with new Laura and thinks she should have heard this from the horse's mouth. Meanwhile, Dr. Alex's head might be turned again. He's just rejected Alexandra because he's interested in new Laura, but now he's considering Stephanie, and it seems she could be keen too. Apparently they get on so well and have such good chats and are now gravitating towards each other. Well, we'll find out just who ends up with who tonight and who's got dumped from the island on the show this evening.
As you can see, we've had a recoupling.
This is so cute!
Give it up for Frankie and Samira! Hashtag Framira. Is anyone using that yet?
Framira. What's the other one?
No, hashtag.
Sankey.
Sankey.
That sounds a bit wrong. Yeah. I don't know.
Sankey and Framira don't. No. Frankie and Samira. We'll go with that. Guys, I think you are the most underrated romance in the island. You are so cute together.
Thank you.
I love you together. Are you ready for your Love Island probing?
Yes.
Yeah?
More than ready.
So, Samira, I have to go to you first because our big question this week, which obviously you can get involved with, you can comment, hashtag under the duvet. What is Alex playing at?
What, with Alex? With, like, the other Alex?
It feels like no one's good enough for him. Is he like very a massive unique player?
No. He's not like that. Dr. Love, you think there, but he's just, I don't know, he's so picky, and I think he finally got something, and he's just like second guessing everything. He thinks too hard, and I'm not in there to tell him off, so.
No, that's the thing. It's like he hasn't got his person.
Right? I would be there in the garden now being like, oi.
Do you think him and Alexandra then are actually good together, or do you think he's going to set his sights on Laura because she's his type?
No, I don't think he'll like jump ship with anyone else. I just think he needs to calm down.
Yeah.
Always gets too ahead of himself.
Yeah.
So calm yourself, Alex.
Calm it. Wind your neck in.
Calm down.
What do we think about Laura? Like, do you think she pushed Jack away?
I think they've been through ups and downs.
I don't know.
They've just been through ups and downs, and like, it's never been easy with them too.
I feel like she's getting a bit of cabin fever. Like, can that happen? Like, do you know what I mean? I feel like she's about to crack. Like,
yeah, I mean, I think because she's gone through so much with like Wes and stuff.
Yeah.
Like, she's just like, oh, again, you know? And it's just like, kind of like the same with me when I like didn't have anything, and then you have something, and then you have something, and you're just like, it's so frustrating in there. You're just like, why? Yeah.
I think Laura did like the, like, she panicked basically.
Yeah.
When Jack went on the date with G, she panicked, and she was like, oh my God, I don't want to get pied off, so I'm going to end it now.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm going to stop this because it's just happened with Wes.
Yeah, she like prematurely ended
Yeah. And then Jack wasn't too bothered by it and didn't give too much of a reaction, and she was like, oh crap.
Like, yeah, actually, like,
I feel like she needs to be taken out, have a like massage.
Little chill
day. Yeah, she needs a chill day. Get your hair done.
And then be put back in, didn't she?
Yeah.
I felt like we didn't actually see loads of your relationship on Love Island. What were we missing, do you think? Like, if you've watched yourself back.
Yeah. Oh, we've not watched it yet. Like, really? I tried to watch it with him yesterday, and I was like, oh, this is cringe. Like, me in the beach hub being like, that Frankie's cute. But I was like, ugh.
Because obviously you said stuff about Frankie that you thought you were just saying to us.
Yeah.
And now you've got
to let me watch it. That's why I had to close my laptop. No, I was like, you don't want to see that.
Too much. We're not there yet.
Yeah.
Too awesome. We're not going to watch that yet.
Okay.
I don't think we'll ever watch it.
No, I wouldn't. No. I would watch it. But she said some lovely things about you. And actually,
you can watch it on your own.
Yeah, said lovely things. We heard, but didn't see, that you guys went to the Hideaway.
Yeah.
For a night. Does that mean you're members of the D-Bit Society?
No, we didn't know.
No, they didn't tell you about that.
What is
that?
What is it? If I did know, then all I could say it's very secret society. So.
Right, okay.
Same with DHS.
It's top secret.
But you're in it. If you knew about it, you'd be in it, I suppose.
I didn't speak to anyone about it.
The first rule of DBS is not to talk about DBS.
Right, okay, yes.
So, I mean, this conversation is
FBI, mate. Right. Jeez!
Okay. Well, we'll move it on. Have you guys moved in together yet?
No.
We haven't moved in, but we have been together every night.
So is Frankie's toothbrush at your house?
Yeah, I sometimes use it.
Yeah,
Are you sharing toothbrushes?
Sometimes we have the same one. I'm like, I don't know, is this yours? Fine, I'll use it.
Yeah. That's
it. We're way too comfortable for.
Yeah, a bit too much.
I suppose you have all that time though in the villa where it's. They say it's like a week is the equivalent of 6 months.
No joke.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So you must come out and you're like, you know, a new couple to some people, but you're like a married couple. Yeah. Like
if we're if we're at home together, it's not like we've just met at all.
Yeah. Too comfortable.
Yeah. What about marriage? Or is that too early? No.
Oh God.
Yeah.
Scaring me, girl.
Too far. Sorry. Let's talk about. So you were in Dream Girls. Are you going to go back to Dream Girls?
No, I won't.
No, you're going to leave that.
Yeah.
Who do you think out of the series so far is going to be like the biggest star to come off the back of the series? Like, apart from you guys, do you know what I mean?
Jack and Danny, definitely.
Danny couple,
and do you think Jackie and Danny, do you think they're gonna win?
Yeah.
You don't think anyone?
They've already won.
Like, when I saw them meet, I thought, you're made.
And when, because you're in there, you see it, is it just like lovely to watch?
They're both obsessed with each other. And together, they're amazing as well. And everyone loves them in the villa. They're cool people.
Lovely people.
Yeah. Samira and Frankie, hashtag. No, we didn't like the hashtag.
Sankey.
You've been amazing.
Doesn't Sankey sound like something you'd say?
That's a club in Manchester, isn't it?
Is it?
It sounds dingy.
I bet it's dingy club.
Yeah,
it's a dingy club.
Great, dingy couple, dingy club.
You've been amazing. That was your Love Island probing. Give it up for Frankie. Thank you, guys. Guys, you're actually... Oh, no, you are getting dumped, but then we're going to bring you back for a game of Mr. and Mrs.
Oh, okay.
To see how well you... Look at that, hitting each other. You're so cute. So cute. But first, we find out what you and the rest of the world have been saying in I've Got a Tweet.
Tweet.
Hey girl, you better check your tweets.
It's just so Muggy.
This week on our top tweets, we are treating our loyal viewers to a loyalty special. Yes, Georgia's Love of the World Loyal has created some of the best memes of all time. In at number 5, this has left singer Loyal Kana feeling very confused. This new delicacy takes 4th place. Chicken Loyal sounds delicious. Taking 3rd, Susan Boyle's got a new name. 2nd goes to Georgia's new startup delivery company. And securing the top spot, move over the royal family, the loyal families in town. And as a wee bonus for you, the official ITV2 and Love Island accounts have also got involved. That's it for me. Back to you, Emily.
Thank you, Lydia. Right, I have recoupled. Give it up for Zara and Adam. I'm back in the bed with Zara and Adam. Guys, are you ready for a game of Mr. and Mrs.?
Of course we are.
Yeah, how well do you know each other?
Okay. I smashed it in the villa.
Good, because you're going to be going head to head with Frankie and Samira. So, Zara, you have the whiteboard. You're going to answer. You're going to write down what you think it is, and then Adam, you'll reveal. Okay, you ready?
Right.
Zara, what is Adam's favourite movie?
Yesterday. I literally said it yesterday.
No, no hints, no cheating.
Can I just blank that one? I don't know it yet.
Guess.
I don't...
Really?
I don't know it yet. I'm sorry. I actually don't know anything.
Don't know anything. Okay. Pass the whiteboard to Adam. Let's see if he actually... We're swapping every time.
Lamborghini.
I would have got that.
Yeah.
I'm just kidding. Okay. Adam, how many Instagram followers does Zara have? You can get it.
I literally showed you earlier.
Okay, it's not just writing a number. This could be awkward. Okay. Zara, how many Instagram followers do you have?
I think it's like 610,000.
610,000. Adam, what did you put?
606. 6 less than Rosie, but not for long.
Oh! We'll give you a point for that. Right, back to Zara. Back to Zara. Okay. Zara, what car does Adam drive? Adam?
The Sculptmobile. It's my little gym van.
Well done. You got it right. I have no idea what that car is.
No, it's just a little gym van.
Oh, right. Okay. Right. Chalkboard back to Adam.
Chalkboard me up.
Okay, Adam. What facial moisturiser does Zara use in the morning?
Oh, facial or leg? I don't...
Do you use the same for your leg and face?
Well, yeah, I use it everywhere.
Oh, okay, so yeah, so leg's fine. Zara?
I use cocoa butter everywhere.
Look at that! Cocoa butter, very good. Okay, final question for Zara. Yep, that's right. Okay. Zara?
Yeah?
Who is Adam's celebrity crush?
Emma.
Oh, God. No, it's fine. We were going to say
Emily Ratchenvatsky, okay, off Blue Lines video.
Guys, that was your round of Mr. and Mrs. Someone was keeping score. Okay. Right, what's going to happen is you're going to be dumped from the bed again. I'm really sorry. No. And we're going to play with Frankie and Samira, and hopefully they will beat you. Oh, no, hopefully they won't beat you. Hopefully they won't. Right, we have recoupled again. I literally cannot keep up. We are in bed now with Frankie and Samira. Hashtag Sankey. Right, this is Mr. and Mrs. So Zara and Adam have already played and they scored 4. So you have 4 to
beat. They're really good in the villa, yeah. I'm worried.
Well, they got 4 out of 5. Right, are you ready? So you've got the your whiteboard. You're going to write the answer, and then Samira, you're going to tell me what the answer is and see if it matches. Okay. Frankie, how many siblings does Samira have? Samira?
1.
Well done! Well done. Jeez. Okay. One right. Okay. Samira with the whiteboard.
Here
you
are.
Okay.
Easy.
Samira, when is Frankie's birthday?
17th of Jan.
Is the right answer. Full house so far. Woo. Okay. How many pets, if any, does Samira have? Samira, what do you have?
One cat.
Okay, put a name on there as well, please. What's the cat called?
Tippy Toes.
Tippy Toes. Yeah. One evil cat, Tippy the Devil.
It did scratch. She did scratch.
Shocking sign. Cat's okay, so that's three points so far. Four house so far.
Did lead you on.
Okay, Samira, what would Frankie say is his worst habit?
I know what she's going to put.
Bad habit. Worst bad habit.
I'm not supposed to see your answer, by the way.
I thought I was going to say something else then. Yeah. Frankie?
I guarantee you she's put sleeping too much.
Nothing all the time. Guys, you are like a married couple.
She doesn't sleep. She just doesn't sleep.
Okay, final question.
Five out of five.
Mate, come
pressure's
on now.
Let's do this. Pressure's on. Yeah, if you get this, then you've won. You've won Mr. and Mrs.
Right. Make it an easy one.
Frankie, what was Samira's first ever job?
You've not got it.
How do you know? Have some faith in him. Think back.
To what, when I knew her before? I know.
Conversations you may have had.
First ever job.
Well, first big job.
Oh.
First job.
First, like...
Yeah, first, like...
Profesh.
Yeah.
Is that how you spell it?
Well, hang on, what?
Yeah, it's Mamma Mia.
Oh, Mamma Mia. Yeah. And they are the winners, give it up for Sankey. They're the winners of Mr. and Mrs. Well done! Oh, sorry, Adam and Zara, they didn't win.
Souls, babes.
That was, sorry, guys, you can, oh, angry, oh, God. Okay.
Oh, God, I'm scared.
I'm really sorry.
You're so tall.
Guys, thank you so much for joining me at Under the Duvet. Give it up for Frankie, Samira, Adam and Zara! We will be back next Thursday with a brand new episode of Under the Duvet. Don't forget to check out Heat Magazine. We've got an exclusive with Samira on Tuesday, and we are going to be talking to Jack's best friend. He's going to be dishing the dirt. I will be back tomorrow morning with the Heat Breakfast Show from 6. Don't forget, there's a brand new episode of Under the Duvet every Thursday. So if you like what you see, subscribe. Press here. Subscribe.